old lady. That's how guys lose their jobs, not collecting fares.
I'm sorry. I guess I'm a little excited.
Thank you, lady.
Good evening.
Good evening. I'm Mrs. Stewart. Would you give me my husband's room number, please? Lieutenant Stewart.
Lieutenant Stewart?
Yes, he's arriving today. I wired for the reservation. Lieutenant and Mrs. Paul Stewart.
You say you wired for a reservation?
Yes, Mrs. Paul Stewart.
I'm afraid there's been a slip-up. Apparently, your wire wasn't received.
But I sent it 3 days ago.
Well, I'm sorry, Mrs. Stewart. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do for you.
You mean I can't stay here?
Well, I wish I could help, but we're completely booked up.
But I've got to stay here. This is the only place we can find each other. I thought for 2 years he was dead, and now I don't know if he's been hurt or what.
Please don't be upset, Mrs. Stewart. Perhaps I can arrange something. Has Mr. Walters checked in yet?
No, sir, not until tomorrow.
Fine, then we can give them 816C for the night. But you will have to leave by noon tomorrow.
Yes, of course. Thank you very much.
Not at all. Will you register, please?
Hello, this is Mrs. Stewart. Did my husband come in? No, thank you.
I've been watching you for months, making a fool of yourself.
I don't think so.
Bringing her here.
Elaine was just about to leave.
I didn't interrupt too soon?
Perhaps it's just as well things worked out like this, Margaret. I've decided to ask you for a divorce.
A divorce?
Well,
Why should I divorce you?
Oh, please, Margaret, let's be sensible. Whatever we had for one another is gone. We've been afraid to admit it before, but it's true. Elaine and I... Well, I love her.
You never loved anyone but yourself.
Please, Margaret.
I was good enough for you once, but now you want someone younger.
It's not that way at all. It's just that I can't go on with you any longer.
All right, Richard. You can have your divorce. You're right. We are strangers. But I have some pride, and no one's going to think you've cast
me off
like
Margaret.
That. You want your precious Elaine, and you can have her. But people are going to know the truth. I'll start right in by telling the room clerk you've been entertaining your girlfriend in our apartment. Then I'll call the newspapers. Careful, cautious Richard. Destroying everything he is for the sake of a cheap
get
little...
away from that
you
phone,
asked for
Margaret.
And you're going to get it.
Leave that phone alone,
I'll enjoy
alone,
telling
Margaret.
Your friends
leave
that you and your lover have been up to...
I hate you.
I'm Lieutenant Stewart.
Oh, yes, Lieutenant. We've been expecting you. Your wife's certainly going to be glad to see you, sir. And Mr. Blake, this is Lieutenant Stewart. Mr. Blake's our manager.
Lieutenant, you really had us worried. I'm glad you finally got here.
For a while, I wasn't sure we'd make it. The weatherman threw the book at us.
Well, you're in for a real welcome.
816C, boy.
Oh, that's all right. I'd kind of like to surprise her.
Very well, sir.
Thanks. What's the matter? Janet. Janet, it's me. It's Paul. Lieutenant Stewart calling. Can you send the house doctor to 816C right away? It's very urgent. Thank you. Well? What is it? What's wrong with her, doctor?
I'm not sure. I think she's suffering from some sort of shock. I'll be frank with you, Lieutenant. This is a little outside my line.
But there must be something you can do for her.
We ought to call in a nerve specialist, a psychiatrist.
Can you suggest one?
There's a very good man in the hotel, Dr. Cross. If we're lucky, we might find him in. This is Dr. Blair. Will you see if Dr. Cross is in for me? Thanks. Cross has had a lot of experience with this sort of thing. I'm all right for a broken arm or an old-fashioned hangover. But when it comes to the mind, well... Hello, Dr. Cross. This is Blair in the hotel. How are you? Say, I've run into something that's right up your alley. One of the guests here has had some sort of shock. No, I don't know what caused it. Oh, would you? Well, that's mighty nice of you. Thanks, Doctor. 816C. He'll be right with us.
She was so alive when I saw her last. I can't quite believe this.
Better snap out of it, Lieutenant. I don't want another patient. Dr. Cross is one of the best men in this part of the country. I'm very happy that he's going to have a look at it.
I don't get it. What could have brought it on?
I wish I could tell you. The mind's a strange instrument. What affects me may not bother you in the slightest. The workings of the mind depend on so many things inside as well as outside. You can't make hard and fast rules.
Well, I suppose it is plausible that she hasn't been feeling well. Worrying about me, not knowing whether I was dead or alive. Then coming here and not finding me.
That'll be Dr. Cross. Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning.
I appreciate your promptness.
Not at all. The sooner you get to a case of shock, the better.
This is Lieutenant Stewart, Dr. Cross.
How do you do, Lieutenant?
Thanks for coming, Doctor. My wife is in the bedroom. She doesn't know me. She doesn't seem to know anything.
Were you here when it happened?
I just got in a few minutes ago. When I opened the door, she was sitting on the divan. Her eyes were wide open. She was staring at nothing.
Did you notice anything peculiar about her actions when you saw her last?
I've been a prisoner of war for 2 years. I've just come home.
Oh, I see.
She's had a rugged time of it, all right. First thinking I was dead, then hearing from me. On top of all that, my plane was 12 hours late.
Would you say that she was a nervous, imaginative girl?
No, sir. I've known her all my life. We came from the same small town in Michigan. Went to school together. She's just a nice kid. What's wrong with her, Doctor?
She's had a nervous collapse, went into shock. Where did you find her?
In the living room.
In the living room? You said she was sitting on the divan.
Yes, right here.
I see.
What do you think could have caused it, Doctor?
Well, that's difficult to say. You have no idea how long she might have been sitting there.
No. Oh, the clerk did say she phoned out about 1 a.m.
Between 1 and 8:30.
What difference does that make, Doctor? The important thing is, what can you do for her?
It's hard for a doctor to make promises. We can only do our best. Are you living permanently at the hotel?
No, as a matter of fact, we've got to clear out by noon.
Oh, I see. But then I'd better take her to my place. She's going to need someone with her night and day.
Dr. Cross has a private sanatorium just out of town.
I see.
Believe me, Lieutenant, it's best for her.
But there must be a hospital here in San Francisco. I'd like to be near her.
Of course. But I'm at my place every day.